Yeah, good morning doctors. Today I will talk about laparoscopic myoma screw. See, I'll show some screws here after that. See, it is most of the time they are made of stainless steel. Only the handle is somewhat plastic. You can see here. There will be some minor differences in the tip of the needle. I'll show you. See, focus this part. There are only two turns here, okay, and this is another one. You can see there are multiple coils. See, this has three parts. This is handle, this is shaft, and this is screw. The screw can have multiple turns like this, or multiple coils, or it can have minimal coils. See here, here the coils are about 5 turns. 5 turns are there. Here 6-7 turns are there. And here you can see only there are 3 turns. But inside there is a needle. You can see a needle inside. Can you focus? You are focusing?
Yes.
You can see a needle here. So these are the varieties of myoma screws. See, I'll tell you, there are few things. If the coils are more, if the turns are more at the tip, if the screw has more turns, the grip is better. Better is the grip, but breaks easily. The problem is, it breaks at this point. If the turns are more, it breaks easily at this point. Okay, but the grip is good. If less coils are there, or if there is a needle in the center, see, I'll show you. Here the number of turns are 1, 2, 3, okay, and there is a center needle here. You can see, if you see carefully, you can see a needle here. If these are there, it is very much durable. In case if you take one, I think it will come lifetime. But the problem is, it slips easily. It slips easily from the myometrium, okay, and it is more durable. Okay, now what are the uses of myoma screw? Myoma screws are used for LAVH, lap assisted vaginal hysterectomy, total laparoscopic hysterectomy. Okay, we can use myoma screw, and we can do it is helpful for doing lap myomectomies also. So regarding TLH, some have the habit of using vaginal manipulators, and some do using myoma screw. You should do few cases. Whichever you feel convenient, you can go ahead with that. If you are comfortable with vaginal manipulator, you can do TLH using vaginal manipulators. If you are comfortable with myoma screw, you can do using myoma screw. Okay. Now I'll talk how to use. Okay. For myomectomy, how to use? I'll tell. Lap myomectomy I am talking. So first you cut the, you see, you know where is the fibroid. You cut the myometrium, outer myometrium, then expose the fibroid, then screw the myoma screw into the fibroid. Then you can do enucleation. Okay, that is when you are using for lap myomectomy. Now I'll come to for TLH, for total laparoscopic hysterectomy. See, what I have shown is, this is uterus, this is fallopian tube, and this is round ligament. So this is left side, this is right side. Okay, now I'll tell where to place the myoma screw. Which part should be screwed? That is very important. So, like, what part you want to do, that is important. If whether you are doing adnexa, or you are doing UV fold, or you are doing uterosacrals, or you want to push the UV fold, or you want to cut the vault. So, depending on that, at what level, right side or left side, what you are doing, depending on that, you have to place the myoma screw. See, when you want to operate on the left adnexa, see, normally when I am talking, you should imagine your table, your patient, your monitor. Okay, now normally I put two ports, two accessory ports on the left side, and one port on the right side I put. So 80% of the surgery I do from left side, because I have two accessory ports on the left side. Okay, now when I want first, so always I stand on the left side when I want to operate on the left side. So I will put the Myanmar screw at the level of the round ligament, usually over the fundus and little anterior, I can say half centimeter or 1 centimeter from the center, from the midline towards the left cornu. I will tell once again, see, I want to operate on the left adnexa. So the Myanmar screw will somewhat come at this point, little anterior to the middle of the fundus and at the level of the round ligament. First I will place it, I will put the Myanmar screw, and it will come from right lateral port. The Myanmar screw, laparoscopic Myanmar screw, will come from right lateral port. Okay, now I will place the Myanmar screw here. Now you should lift the uterus. See, this point is very important. You should lift the uterus, you shouldn't pull the uterus. If you pull the uterus, the Myanmar screw will automatically come out. So you lift the uterus so that the adnexal parts are stretched. So you now cut fallopian tube, round ligament, ovarian ligament, and now you come down along the broad ligament, you come to the UV fold. So when you want to expose the UV fold, you see, lifting the uterus is common, but you push the uterus posteriorly towards the sacral promontory. You try to understand. I want to push the UV fold. Now I will push the fundus towards the sacral promontory so that the UV fold will be exposed. Now I will cut and push the UV fold, I will push the bladder down, then I want to operate posteriorly, I want to cut the uterosacrals. Now when I want to cut the uterosacrals, I will push the uterus anteriorly towards the pubic symphysis so that uterosacrals will be exposed. Then like that I will go, I will cauterize the uterines, push the vascular bundle down, and then I will cut the vaginal vault. At every step you see to that there is stretch at the part where you are operating to avoid the injury to the bladder and ureter. So always lift the uterus and push anteriorly or posteriorly or bit sidewards to expose the part that you want to operate. Okay, to operate on the part, it should be exposed. So either you push to the push anteriorly or push posteriorly, and always lifting the uterus and giving traction is very important. Everything is done by Myanmar screw. Okay, now I have written here to operate on the left adnexa, put it near the left cornu, bit anterior. Okay, lift the uterus. Okay, yeah, all this thing I have told. Then, so I have written some marks here. What are these marks? See, as you proceed downwards, see, you are operating on the adnexa and the Myanmar screw you have put here. As you reach the uterosacrals and when you push the UV fold, you may think the traction is not enough. So that time you should advance the Myanmar screw, you remove from there and put it down. You can put it down as and when required. Okay, sometimes occasionally we have put just above the UV fold like this, here like this we have put, but most of the time for a normal sized uterus or just bulky uterus, at a single placement of the Myanmar screw just at the level of the fundus will be enough to complete 80% of the surgery on the left side. Okay, that's what, see, these are the places where we put Myanmar screw. Nothing like here you should put, there you shouldn't put. You just, when you do 100 cases, you will realize where exactly you should put the Myanmar screw. See, if it, you put the Myanmar screw, in case the traction is not adequate or you are not able to do the surgery, you change the place. With the time, you will come to know where you should put the, how much traction you should exert, how much uterus should be pulled up, how much uterus should be lifted. Everything you will come to know when you do about 50-100 surgeries. So I was telling 80% of the work is done from left side and another 20% I do it on the right side. Okay, and then what are the problems or complications encountered when you are using Myanmar screw? I will tell whatever I am telling, that is out of my experience. Okay, first one is slippage of screw. See, you put the screw comes out. So when it happens, I told in the beginning only, if the spirals are less and if there is a center needle, there are more chances of the Myma screw slipping out. So I have written here, spirals are less and spiral with a new needle, the grip is less, so slippage chances are more. And whenever you infiltrate the uterus with vasopressin combined with adrenaline, again the slippage chances are more. And if there is a subserous fibroid or intramural fibroid just beneath the place where you want to screw, there also the slippage chances are more. So number one problem is slippage of screw, that is very common. Next, coming to bleeding from the screwed areas. See, bleeding from the screwed areas is normally quite acceptable. It may be 50 ml or 100 ml, usually less than that. But in case sometimes it is so irritating, occasionally I remember one or two cases we converted to abdominal also, because the big veins over the surface of the uterus started bleeding so much, I couldn't control. I opened abdomen and converted into total abdominal hysterectomy. But such things are extremely rare. Okay, usually the screwed area, that bleeding from there stops with coagulation, bipolar coagulation, or it stops with time. It bleeds 20 or 30 ml, then it stops. Okay, then another problem with myoma screw is breakage. What is the breakage? Breakage is this tip breaks. This portion will break. See, this may not break because there is continuity, but I'll show you this this type usually. Yeah, there is long spiral here. This breaks easily. Okay, this breaks and it may fall into the it can break down. Again, after breaking down, there are two problems. One thing, it can fall into the peritoneal cavity. This piece breaks and falls into the peritoneal cavity. So now the issue is how to remove it. How to remove it is very important issue. You take a needle holder, laparoscopic needle holder, catch the tip. See, the tip which is broken down should be caught, and you bring it to the tip of the port. You should bring, then pull along with the cannula. The 5 mm port cannot accommodate this broken tip. That 5 mm cannula cannot accommodate. What I want to tell is, see, just I'll show you in a diagram. Imagine this is the cannula. This is outside, this is abdomen. The broken tip, this is broken tip. You bring it here up to this, then pull this one also, this broken tip also, and pull out the cannula also. So it will come out through this 5 mm port easily. And don't try to accommodate this tip into the cannula. It is not possible. That is one thing. And another important thing I want to tell, that is, remove from the lower port. See, left side I told I have put two ports. One is 1 inch above the anterior superior iliac spine. Another one is at the level of the umbilicus. See, don't remove from the upper port. Always remove from the lower port, because when you are trying to remove from the upper port, in case if it is lost in the peritoneal cavity, it is very difficult to trace it. So never remove from the upper port. Always remove from the left lower port. It is easy to, because just it falls in the iliac fossa. Again, if it falls also, you can catch hold of it and you can remove it. Okay. Next, with breakage only, there is another problem. When it breaks, it can stuck into the uterine myometrium. It can get stuck so deep into the myometrium. It is very difficult to remove it from the uterus. So, okay, leave it like that. Just keep an eye, because it may slip out and fall into the abdominal cavity, but normally it doesn't happen. It happens two times in my experience. It got screwed into the myometrium. So what I did, I continued using another myoma screw. I did TLH, and then I removed the tip from the specimen. Then I finished TLH. Then the tip was removed from the specimen. Then the problems or complications encountered with myoma screw is injury to the rectum. See, whenever always in laparoscopy, a medium sized uterus or just bulky uterus is very good to do TLH. If the uterus is too big and if it is very much distorted, again TLH is difficult. And if uterus is too small, again the problems are many. I'll tell you again with this. If you have a small postmenopausal uterus to remove, she is for TLH. If you screw deep into the myometrium, it can penetrate, it can go through and through, and it can penetrate into the rectum. So be careful in postmenopausal uterus. Next, number 5, the complication, no place to put screw. See what happens if uterus is very small, you have put at two or three places, and if uterus is friable and if the tissue gets avulsed over the fundus here and there, then you don't have any place to put the myoma screw only. So that time it happened 2-3 times. So I have completed TLH by holding the uterus using a tenaculum. So I completed TLH using tenaculum. This can happen with postmenopausal small uterus. Okay, next. Number 6, bending of the tip. See this tip, I told you, see this tip, the spiral is so long. So when you screw and when you move the uterus front, back, sidewards, so this portion can bend. This portion can bend. Okay. So what will happen if spirals are more, bends frequently? So what you should do if it bends, you should straighten it inside. Using a needle holder, you should make it straight. Then you should take it out. Suppose if bent tip is pulled without straightening it, so it can damage the ports. If the ports are made of plastic, like there are plastic ports also, it can damage the ports and it can damage the washers also. So that's about myoma screw. Thank you.